change of scenery today.
The English Light District.
Glenridding with the Pedronator.
Hi there.
We are going to be...
It's very unusual to see us going south.
Yeah, we're down south today. We're hitting Helvellyn via Striding Edge. It's the English equivalent of the Aonach Eagach Ridge, so we'll see how scary it is. So, you pass by a camping site from the car park. You cross over the other side of the road, walk up the opposite side of the burn from where the car park is. You pass by a camping site on your left, which is down there. And then you start going off-road here. So, Helvellyn via Myersbeck, 3 miles. Where we've came, where we're going to. An Ullswater steamer going by there. It's pretty full. That's Glenridding down there. And that's the path up. And the mountain opposite. So there's Pedro. That's the way to go. That baby over there, 675 metres. And the prow is called Heron Point. And the bit behind is called Sheffield Point. So that's looking back to Glenridding and Ullswater. Don't see any steamers. Not something you come across in Scotland very often. A dry stain dike, or a wall, as it's known, around about these bits. And we need to go through the hole in the wall later on. We'll get some cash out. Reached 2,000 feet now, that's 2,000 feet. That's the way ahead. So it's the opposite way from the wall. But we're going to turn back and meet that wall again. And get through the hole and withdraw our money from the hole in the wall. So we've reached 2,100 feet. And now we can see Striding Edge. Which is way up here. And there are people on it just now. That looks a piece of pie. Me and Pedro have done Aonach Eagach. And there you come down Swirral Edge. Not squirrel, but Swirral. For now. And then you drop down to the tarn, have a swim in there. So we follow the wall, and you can see a way up there is the hole in the wall, which is a misnomer now, because it's a stile over a hole in a wall. Onto the Striding Edge, which is that little baby there, and at the end of them a scrambling up to the summit, which is there. Helvellyn via Striding Edge. So there's the famous tarn. We're out with Pedro again.
Hello.
And it's a roaster a day, hottest day of the year so far. So that's Swirral Edge Ledge. That's the way down. Once you hit there, you're on the proverbial motorway. So that's looking back to where we came. We walked all the way along that dry stained dike, Ullswater behind. Sending the warthogs. So that's the striding edge there. The rock at the back of it. And then the scramble up onto the top of Helvellyn. And then to go down. Your way down over this stuff. And then you're on a motorway. So that's where we came from. Pedro having his coffee. We were hoping the A10 warthogs were going to blast through that valley, but I think we're out of luck. We almost finished the striding edge. White ants they are. The top of the hill. Hands on, scrambling. So you can see the sea away over there in the distance. Don't know what that big hill is, but we'll find out. And all of a sudden we're on the ridge. This is it. Striding edge. So camera away while we do it. So we're on top of the striding ledge just now. There's the exposure you've got. So it's not unlike the Aonach Eagach, that side there. Not as exposed. Down to the tarn. And of course the end of it and the top's up there. There's a plaque of some significance. Can't even read what it says anymore.
But basically, in other words, the last person that tried to do this spot ended up panbred.
Panbred. D-E-A-D. Deed. Like Socky Hall Street behind us. Sorry, my bad, we're in England today. It's like Oxford Street behind us. Yeah, we'll get the classic shot of the ridge when we've completed it and we're up the tap. Here we have some folks coming behind us doing a bit of rock hopping. It really isn't difficult.
Compared to the stuff that we've done back home in Scotland, this is relatively easy so far.
Name some other stuff, Peds.
The Aonach Ridge, the Forking Ridge. The exposure up here doesn't really match up to the Aonach Eagach Ridge at all, does it?
Nah. We're about halfway over it now. this looks like the most exposed bit, because it's a fair old fault in that side. So me and Pedro are going to go to the right here. Not worth taking videos, doing it, because we're chicken. Me and Pedro are chicken. So there's Pedro on his favourite bypass path. He likes them. Some girls in front of us. Not chicken at all. It's not that far to go. Okay, so Peds is going to show us how to do a bypass path. On you go, Peds. Right, go on you go then. No, he's going to do some scrambly hands on. On you go, Peds. Just stick to the rock. So we're getting to the end of the striding edge. It's been all right, isn't it, Peter?
Aye.
A bit of exposure, but not the right aim about. This reminds us of the Forkan Ridge, doesn't it, Peds?
That's right, with the...
scramble at the end. A bit windy up here, for sure. Because there's the exposure over there. Quite exposed. Right, we've reached the end of the shrine edge. So it's that chimney there, or it's something over here. After that, it's the rock climb, scramble, summit. So this is the chimney, is it they call it, at the end? Peds done it. Well done, Peds. Happy with that?
Aye.
There's folk heading off over the far side. That's the way we'll begin down. Exactly. So it's a cricket climb in the day of the Cairn. That's a piece of pie. If you can do the Aonach Eagach, that's right on the Aonach Eagach. Wee bit of hands on here. That scrambling there, that was rock scrambling, that was superb. Totally loved that. We helped that lassie from Holland, go down the drop. That's where we came from, way over there. Pedro taking photos. The Dutch folk are thinking of coming. There you have it. Striding edge. That's a bit at the end. The chimney, they call it. Dutch lassie didn't like that. And you've got the climb. Hands on all climbing up there, which is great. Then it's just some loose scrambling, which is easy peasy in it, Peds.
That's right, nothing too exposed.
And I was just saying, this reminds me of Ben Crookin with a big dam in the mountains at either side. Well, there's a Corbett at Crookin as well as Stop Dam. Boy, I'm naked. One of your mates, Pedro.
Right.
Shot that coat off. Warmest day of the year, eh, Peds?
Aye.
Look at the views. On a hoolie up here. Well done, Pedro. Helvellyn via Striding Edge. Whew. Views from up here today are stupendous. Look, there it is, copter in the valley. Come on, you must be able to see it.
That's a dolphin.
Is it? I'm just saying to Pedro, it's like Mars up here. It's probably because there's been that many folk. It's like, wow! Pedro getting the coffee out before we go down the Swirral ledge. Let's go. I need to check my notes. But it's going to be down here anyway. Helvellyn via Striding Edge. Swirral edge, we came down the Swirral, went up the Striding over there, along the top, and down the Swirral. What did you think of the Swirral edge, Peter?
Great, wasn't it?
Fun. Scrambling, exposure, superb. I think that's it for a wee while with the photos. Well, that was Swirral edge, and that's Striding edge. You can see there's a fair amount of exposure. I don't fancy that bypass path at all. It's a bit too exposed for me. I'd rather go in the rocks at the top. That's where it starts, just up there, and it finishes with the climb out, climb down the chimney there, the climb up the rocks there, and then an easy ascent on some scree crap, and that's a cracking little descent on the squirrel wedge. What better thing to do after climbing Helvellyn than just to strip off and get right in there? Well done. Well done, you two. I'm not going to say anything about shagging it.
Get my camera back at Wales.